Inside the Capitol Rotunda on Inauguration Day, I'm Dave Morris alongside my colleague Ben Felder from The Oklahoman. And Ben, we will soon have the next governor of Oklahoma officially sworn in.
Yeah, Kevin Stitt will become Oklahoma's 28th governor. That's expected to happen somewhere around noon. He and eight other statewide officials will take their oath today in a transition of power on this big Inauguration Day here at the Capitol.
It's early right now. The media is outside getting set up. The choir is going through their routine. The various official festivities are kind of walking through the last minute stuff before things get going. It's free to the public if you want to come out south side of the outside of the Capitol. And Ben, I'll let you kind of walk us through today of what people can expect if and when they come out here.
Yeah, the ceremony is going to begin at 11:30. And like I said, that inauguration ceremony is mainly focused on Stitt, but there'll be eight other statewide officials, attorney general, lieutenant governor and such. And then about 12:05, we're expecting the newly appointed governor Stitt to deliver his inauguration speech. So he'll be standing at the platform that's been built on the south steps of the Capitol, overlooking a crowd that, based on the chairs and the bleachers, could be a couple thousand, maybe more, overlooking the south end of the Capitol towards the skyline of Oklahoma City. And then following that, there'll be a reception here in the Capitol. Tonight is the governor's ball, which will be in downtown Oklahoma City. And, Governor Stitt and these other officials officially take office today, but most of today will still be kind of a day of celebration and ceremony before the real work begins tomorrow.
Real quick, what are you expecting to hear today?
Well, I think, in Stitt's speech, we're going to hear, a lot of the same things we heard from the campaign trail, but I think it's going to be kind of a message of hope and trying to inspire Oklahomans to say, hey, we don't have to take second standing to anybody, which has been something that Stitt has talked a lot about. I think he's going to try to inspire confidence in a state government that has maybe lost a lot of confidence among voters in recent years. Probably one of the reasons why Stitt, won the election, or at least why he emerged from the Republican primary as this complete political outsider, unknown name, and knocked off some pretty heavy-hitting Republicans in the primary. So I think we're going to hear Stitt say, hey, that we're going to try to, turn the state around, the Oklahoma turnaround, obviously one of his biggest phrases. But, I'm also curious, what kind of policy are we going to hear? Just like in the State of the State address, you're always kind of pay attention, what is most important to the governor that they're going to mention? I expect him to talk about education funding and teacher pay. I expect him to talk about his desire to have more control over state agency heads, hiring and firing power and that such. But what else is he going to mention? Is he going to talk about criminal justice reform? Is he going to mention any specifics on that front? This is a significant platform that he has to set the tone for his administration. And while I think a lot of it will be, I don't mean to say fluff in a bad way, but will be kind of more inspiring and kind of more message creating, I want to know, are we going to see some specific policies referenced? And that will be interesting to see, how does he start his new administration? What tone does he take?
His address expected to be begin just after noon today. You can watch that live on newsok.com, and if not, you can watch it on demand at your leisure whenever you like on newsok.com. Be sure to follow Ben Felder and our other colleagues throughout the day on Twitter, social media, and on newsok.com for live updates throughout the day as the proceedings and the ceremonies and the festivities continue into the ball tonight. Alongside Ben Felder, I'm Dave Morris. Stay with NewsOK for more updates from the State Capitol.